afternoon, everyone. This is Kevin Gianni from the Renegade Health Show, and here we're here with Farmer Brown.
That's me.
This is Ken Brown, and this is Peggy Donnell, and they own Angels Organic Farm as well as Angels
Health Institute.
Mm-hmm. And we just spent the weekend here for Matt and Angela Stokes' wedding. And where are we in Oregon?
Southern Oregon, right off I-5, just north of Ashland, about 30 miles.
So. All right, yeah, cool.
North of Ashland. Rogue Valley, beautiful area.
And so we just had a great dinner with them, and Peggy was telling her personal story, which we'll talk a little about today. And then Ken's got his whole operation here, which we're going to get into too. So I think maybe we'll start with that. You know, you walk into the greenhouse and there's a bunch of music, and so, you know, what the heck's going on?
Good question. The program here was to develop some of the most medicinally nutrient food available to give people the biggest jump start in life that they can get. But we grow everything here in ocean water. We use sound frequencies, mineral frequencies, paramagnetic work, and subtle energy. So those are some of the protocols that we use with the plants, and they've been really able to do some amazing things here.
And what does the sound frequency do?
Sound frequencies was developed, when I studied it, was developed by Dan Carlson, and he owned a company called Sonic Plume, and talked to him many times on the phone. The work that I've done in the other greenhouses, when you play the sounds that he's developed, it's not just music, there's specific frequencies that he works with. And I put a single speaker in the greenhouse about 100 feet long and played it throughout the season. The first plant closest to the speaker would be 4 feet tall, the next one is 3.5 feet tall. 100 feet away, the plant would be about this far off the ground.
God.
It was a perfect line all the way down. And I go, there's something to this program. So we've really worked on the sound. I've worked with Dr. Leonard Horowitz, which is the healing codes, some of the universal frequencies coming from outer space. There's all kinds of ways that you can implement these. And what they do, the sounds themselves open up the stomata on the leaves. The back of the leaves have these little stomata, which is kind of a mouth.
I call them the mouth.
Open. Yeah. Mm. And they actually open up during this time frame. So we like to play the music only early in the morning or later in the evening, about this time, dusk. And that's when the plants take in the nutrients. That it's like a bunch of candies and goodies, a direct IV injection bypassing the whole root system.
Right.
Mm-hmm. So it'll pull it in right through the leaves. And this helps them. In nature, if you listen in the back of here, you'll kind of almost hear birds chirping.
Yeah, it's nice.
Crickets, you know, and bugs and those kind of things. Get up at 4 o'clock in the morning, and what do you hear out here in the farm?
Mm-hmm.
You should be hearing all those frogs and all those sounds are there for a reason, and they're doing an amazing job with the plants. And when you lose that biodiversity out there, you're losing some of the nutrient values that the plants can absorb. So that's what we've had to, we're manipulating what we've lost in nature here.
But Peggy, I wanted to ask you a little bit about the Health Institute, what you're doing, and, you know, kind of your own transformation, because we saw some pictures, and it's pretty impressive.
Well, with the Health Institute, what brought us to the Health Institute was, of course, because I got sick, which is really sad that we all have to get sick in order to change something. So when we started the Institute, I was at my first clinic, and when I got home, I had this huge raw food kitchen done. So we started the clinic so we could help educate people in changing their life of what they're eating. I was all raw food for 3 years, and I went to raw vegan, and then I've kind of turned a little bit. Now I'm raw. I'm probably more raw than I was before, but I'm adding so many more things into my diet, the sauerkrauts, the kefirs, tons of sprouts, finding that my health is actually getting better that way, plus a whole lot of raw food in the diet. So I'm teaching people in a balance. I call it balance and motion, because we all have to be changing. We're doing this, we're doing that, it's not quite working, so let's just keep balancing that and see where it's going. So at the Institute, that's what I work with on people, is just teaching people to listen to their own body, pay attention to what they're eating, keep your blood work up, so you know where you're at.
Tell me a little bit more about the blood work. Because we're big advocates of that.
The blood work is so important. I was hospitalized here last year, and it ended up being a B12 deficient, a vitamin D deficient, my thyroid,
protein
deficient. So if I wasn't keeping track of that and just kept eating more raw food or just kept doing things, I would not be at the health where I'm at right now. So I think it's real important that we can't just think one thing is going to take care of it. We have to constantly be checking ourselves. We do blood work every 6 months. Mm-hmm. Right now I'm doing it every 3 months because I'm so low on other things. I have to keep it up every 3 months to see where I'm at. So it's real important to really know that we need both sides. We need the medical side and we need the organic food side. Mm-hmm. And we're not getting, we got to remember that the organic foods that we're getting in the store, I mean, they're great organic foods, but they're also missing things because the soil's missing. So obviously if the soil's missing, the plant's missing. So we do have to keep it balanced and keep it checked.
We call it the missing link. You know, the health world's all buying all the organic food, and our motto at the farm is know your food, know your farmer. So I encourage everybody that comes through mm-hmm. the clinic to go home and help educate their own private farmers. Say, hey, look, you need to up what you're doing so we can, as consumers, get better food from you. Mm-hmm. There's always more we can add to the program. You know, and one of my specialties is with wheatgrass. I've been studying it for a long time. I get a kick because it's one of those things that they always really push at clinics, and it's an important, really important mm-hmm. tool that I think everybody needs in life. And it's just one of those things like, oh God, I have to have some wheatgrass, you know, and I'll do what it takes. Or they plug their nose and they try to push it down, and so I thought, well, I can make it better, mm-hmm. and I have done that. And the subtle energy world is what has really manipulated the taste of it. I've been able to drop the sugars, which is an important fact in any health clinic, to drop mm-hmm. your sugars out of any plants, and the uptake the minerals, because it's all grown in ocean water too. Okay. But I think
How have you manipulated it? What?
Subtle energy.
Without giving us the industry secrets, right?
Well, I will never be able to do that because I don't truly understand. I work with a Russian quantum physicist who mm-hmm. does that side of things. I was lucky enough to build his laboratory for him.
That started that whole thing.
Yeah, so I saw his technology and I go, wow, you could do some really neat things with this. And he didn't understand anything in the plant world. So I developed a delivery system for subtle energy. So he infuses specific patterns. I give him like a formula. I'm saying, okay, my plants, the wheatgrass loves lithium and hydrogen. So I've actually had him imprint the DNA structure of compost itself, and I work with a compost pile that comes from all over the world, mm-hmm. and so I've imprinted that compost structure and have that that subtle energy pattern coming from there, and I have that actually infused into pure silica crystals. And once I've infused all these different, I've got about 10 to 12 different protocols in there, I've created a delivery system that I can run water through, pick up all these energetic patterns, and deliver it to the plants. They react as if they have those, even though they're not there. Hmm. So it's an important tool to use. Is it the correct thing? Not necessarily. But in the planet that we live in, we have to raise the bar, the energetic values of where we're at. And this is one great way of doing it with a low footprint on the planet. We're not destroying anything, and we can create these great tools. My mycorrhizal is double what it used to be, which is one of the reasons why we're picking up more of the minerals and dropping the sugars using the subtle energy work.
Yeah. And this weekend, everybody was like, this is the best wheatgrass they've ever had. We just could not even keep up with doing the wheatgrass.
It's the like, David Wolf scenario. Yeah. The best ever.
The best ever. You know, how he says best ever. That's what everybody was saying. I go, wow, wow.
Then
so
I
they
think
were just constantly
is.
Coming back and coming back from where wheatgrass.
That's great. Well, guys, thanks for sharing.
So your question of the day is wheatgrass, like the taste or not? Go ahead and post it down below. This is Kevin Gianni from the Renegade Health Show. Together we can change the health of the world, one show at a time.